Hi, this is Ramu, Associate Professor, Department of CSE, Institute of Aeronautical Engineering, Hyderabad. In last class, we have seen how to apply inheritance in Python, right? In this class, we are going to see how to apply abstraction and as well as the polymorphism. You know, we have four features of object-oriented programming language. First one is the inheritance, abstraction, polymorphism, right? So here, first one is the abstraction. Abstraction means Python is a process of hiding a real-world implementation of an application from the user and emphasizing only on usage of it. Means, if you observe the ATM machine, you don't know how to process, inside process of withdrawing money. But you know only one thing, what it is? If you insert a card into the ATM and enter to the proper pin, then you'll get a money. But you don't know what is the process inside. Means that is a hiding. It means real-world implementation is hide from the user. User doesn't know what happened inside. User want to know how to get the money from the ATM, right? Means here, abstraction will help you to hide the real-time implementation, means which you don't want, right? For example, even if you consider your two-wheeler, if you press the brake, means the vehicle will stop, right? But you don't know what is the process behind the braking system. Even that is not required for you, right? Like that. The software point of view also, no need to know everything. So if you want to hide the implementation from the user, client, you just apply abstraction. See, if you want to apply the abstraction, you should implement the ABC, abstract control data type. Abstract control data type. For that reason, you should import ABC package. By using ABC package, you can implement the abstraction. I'll show you how to implement the abstract class in the editor, right? This is the purpose of the abstraction. Coming to the private and public, in normal languages, like C language, if you want to declare a variable, global variable, you can access from anywhere. Means you don't have any restriction to control the particular variable. If you want to control the particular variable, you have to mention that variable how to restrict the particular variable, you need some access specifier. For example, if you consider the Java, you have four kinds of access specifiers are there. Private, public, protect, as well as default. Coming to the C++, you have only three access specifiers. Private, public, protect. But coming to the Python, you have two access specifiers. This is the private and public. By using the private and public, you can control the variables from accessing from the outside of the class. If you declare a variable as a private, then you don't have a permission to access the particular variable from the outside of the class. If you declare a variable as a public, then you have a permission. You have a access to retrieve that particular data of the variable. That is the purpose of the private and public. Based on some implementation, hiding purpose, you are going to use the private and public, right? See, for example, if you consider here class of employee. Employee is a data, right? In the employee class, you declare the name and salary. Name and salary. See, these two variables are the public variables. You can access from anywhere. But how to declare a private variables? See, if you want to declare a private variable, you should use a double underscore with the variable name. For example, if you want to name as a private variable, then please note this self underscore dot double underscore and name equal to IARE. Then you don't have a permission to access the particular variable from the outside of the class because this is the private variable. And if you consider the salary, this is a public variable. You have a permission to access the particular variable from the outside of the class. That is the beauty of the private. Only when you want to hide data from the user outside of the world, then you can use this kind of procedure, private and public access specifiers. Please note this. Protect is there. If you use only one underscore, then it is a protect, but you don't have any extra functionalities for the protect. Protect is works like what it is called your normal public. That is why. So only please consider private and public is working with the Python, right? Next, encapsulation. If you observe the encapsulation, is the process of wrapping up a variable and methods into a single entity, right? So if you consider the class, so a class contains, how the class looks like? See, a class contains, what is a class? A class is a blueprint of an object, means it's a plan of an object. Object is a real-time entity, right? So in every object, it contains a variables, right? It contains a variables and methods. Methods. That is the thing there. So a single entity. Entity is a real-time object. Real-time object. In a programming, a class is an example that wraps all the variables and methods defined inside of it. Right? Right? So the polymorphism encapsulation is possible with the object-oriented concept. The encapsulation means just wrapping your methods as well as the variables in the object related to the particular object, right? Next to polymorphism. Poly means, if you observe, the poly means is the many forms. If you want to use the same variable, same method name multiple times, then it is called as a polymorphism. Have two kinds of polymorphisms are there. Dynamic polymorphism as well as a static polymorphism. See, a polymorphism defines a methods in the child class that have the same name as the methods in the present in the parent class. It's called as a method overriding. Method overriding comes under the dynamic polymorphism. In inheritance, the child class inherits the methods from the parent class. See, I'll show you one thing. For example, class A is there and class B is there, right? In class B, class A add method is there, right? You can write the same method in class B also, and B inherits the A. Then this is called as a method overriding. And method overriding comes under the dynamic polymorphism. But what about the method overloading? Method overloading means the same name with the different arguments, method name. Then it is called as a method overloading. Method overloading comes under the static polymorphism. See, polymorphism, two types. Dynamic polymorphism and static polymorphism. Dynamic polymorphism example is method overriding. Static polymorphism example is method overloading. And dynamic polymorphism example is method overriding. There is a difference between the dynamic polymorphism as well as the static polymorphism. We'll see one by one in the editor. First, I'm going to implement abstraction. How abstraction will work. For example, if you consider one class, what it is called? Vehicle. A vehicle is a class, right? It is a base class of a remaining classes, right? Vehicle. For example, if you consider the vehicle, see, class vehicle. Right. So here it contains a method. What is the moving? Moving is a move. Right. But please note this. Before going to implement abstraction, you should import the ABC package. See, import ABC. From ABC, right? This is the abstract method, right? So if you mention as abstract, you should use a pass, means this method is over here. Next, you are going to implement the subclass. Vehicle subclass is two wheeler and four wheeler. The both are comes under the vehicle class only, right? See, class two wheeler. It inherits the vehicle class. Here you need to write def of move. So print I am two wheeler, right? Moving. After that, one more class. What it is called? Four wheeler. right? Again, it inherits the same base class def of move c. You just consider the same message, but it's a 4, right? Here, class of v. If you create an object for the four-wheeler, see, f dot, what is the method? Move, right? Yes. Move takes a zero position argument, but one is, yes. See, these are the class methods, right? If it is a class method, you should use self as an argument. When you mention self, then only it consider for the object method. See, I am moving, right? For example, it's a 4, right? If you consider here two-wheeler, right? So here you are going to hide the information from the below classes by using abstract, right? Is this clear? This is the way you're going to implement the abstraction. Now we'll see how to implement the public and private variables. Here I'm going to take one variable, that is the name. So name equal to IARE, right? This is the name class variable. Now we created an object. What it is called? Object is for V. For V class, you just create an object. And if you print of v dot name. See, this is the output. IRE is the output. For example, if you make it this one as a private, then see what is the output here. Name is not found because name is a private variable. So you don't have access from outside of the class. That is the purpose of the private variables, right? Private is an access specifier. If you want to achieve the private, you should use double underscore, right? Is this clear? And I'm going to show you a polymorphism. See, here move is there, right? This is the parent class. This is the subclass. This is called as the same method name in base class as well as the subclass. Then that kind of scenario is called as a method overriding. Method overriding comes under the dynamic polymorphism, right? Is this clear? So in the today class, we have seen how to implement the abstraction and how to use the private and public keywords, right? As well as how to apply the polymorphism. In the next class, we'll see how to implement a object oriented program for the given class diagram. Okay, thank you very much.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.